rose and Christ also.
All right, you think this is something that you would like to put together again?
Yeah, oh yes, yes.
Yeah,
yes.
This is a continuous process now.
Yes, it is.
After 40 years.
Yes.
All right.
I give it all to him up there.
Yeah.
My friend Mason, she'll be on the phone.
Hello.
How are you?
How you doing?
I'm well. I'm
all right,
well.
And where you live?
I live in New Orleans, Louisiana, on the West Bank of New Orleans.
Yeah, on the West Bank now. You went to school here in Franklinton?
Yes, I'm a graduate of Franklinton Washington Parish High School.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm excited to be home, visiting with my family, and being here with all my classmates and having such a wonderful time the last couple of days. We just had an exciting time, and we're just looking forward to the culmination here today. And just seeing everyone has truly, truly, truly excited me. I've been waiting for this for 40 years.
Yeah.
Now,
seeing some of the students, how did you leave Louisiana and go to New Orleans?
Oh, well, I was
the New Orleans.
I joined the military, and after joining the military, I was in there for 8 years. And then I got married, and my husband was from New Orleans, so I ended up in New Orleans.
Yeah.
And that's where I've been since that time.
Yeah.
And I had a daughter, and she would be 24 now, but she's deceased. And I adopted a son, and his name is Howard. And he's 14, and my husband is a minister of St. Mary Missionary Baptist Church in Marrero, Louisiana.
Yeah.
And I'm the first lady of that church.
All right. Yeah, now let's just step in here. I want to ask you something. Now, this is Washington Parish, class of 69, and they got a tiger there. What's the tiger representing?
That was our logo, our mascot.
Yeah, okay.
Right. You know, I'm having a memory lapse here. So, yeah, that was our mascot. We was the Mighty, Mighty Tigers.
Yeah.
And we were excited about being here today. You can just feel the excitement in the air. We've been planning for at least since January.
Uh-huh.
And here it is today that we will finalize. We will end up at Tate's Place where we will have dinner this afternoon, and then we will descend back to our homes.
Yeah.
Pray to God that he will give us traveling grace, that we will arrive there safe and sound.
Yeah, but thank you so much. I'm going to ask this auditorium here. It looks like a nice auditorium.
This
it's been around 40 years?
Oh, yeah.
Uh-huh.
More than 40 years.
Yeah.
This is where we have all our plays and graduation ceremonies.
Uh-huh.
And we took a tour to school on Friday, October the 23rd. And we just came in, and this is where we always gather for all functions of the school.
Yeah.
From the primary to the high school.
And here it is, 40 years later, you're back in the same auditorium.
Back at the same place. It looks wonderful, and they've kept it up, and it's looking beautiful.
All right, and thank you so much.
You're welcome.
All right. Another lady with her cap and gown on, and what's your name?
Gloria Simmons.
Miss Simmons, how you doing?
Fine, and you?
Great, great.
Yes.
Now, you were class of 69.
Yes.
Yeah. Now, where do you live at now?
Independence, Louisiana.
Independence, Louisiana. Well, we noticed a lot of people left Franklinton. Talking to one young man, he said before he graduated, all he could think about was working at the Bogalusa paper mill. But he went to New York.
Okay.
Yourself, why did you leave?
Oh, well, I joined Jumpport when I first left, and I went to Texas, from Texas to Michigan, from Michigan on to Boston, back to Detroit, then back to Metairie, Louisiana, and now I'm in Independence.
Yeah. Now, we notice most of these classmates here seem to be doing well, and life has blessed them. God has been good to them. What do you do today?
Oh, I'm assistant manager at Sally's Beauty Supply in Hammond, Louisiana.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So you have maintained employment as a result. Now, education, what would you advise young people today? After 40 years, you're back at this auditorium, a lot of your classmates, and you see the results of education. You had to advise. What would you say?
Keep their hand in God's hand and
Let
him direct them.
Yeah.
And everything will turn out all right.
All right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Now, young lady, you're sitting here, and I see you have a pad. It looked like you're kind of making sure everything is going well.
Well, actually, I am the finalizer, if you will. I'm the one that will have the closing remarks.
Yeah.
I'm the one that will bring tears to the eyes.
Oh, okay.
I'm the one that will take us back in the beginning of 1969.
Yeah.
when we thought about what we wanted to be and what we did not want to be in those halls at Washington Parish High School.
Yeah.
And I just wanted to talk about those days of walking in those halls.
Yeah.
Our mental state.
Yeah.
Some days happy, some days sad.
Mm-hmm.
But simply carefree, though, most.
Yeah. We know at one time it was segregation in the educational system. That changed. Do you think it changed that helped African Americans to do better?
Well, you know what? I was one of the first of three that integrated Franklinton High School.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, one thing that I have always talked about was the fact that when I started school there, I was shocked at the new books.
Mm-hmm.
And the book read vocabulary, and I'm sitting there wondering, what is vocabulary? Because I had never had that class in school at Washington Parish High.
Yeah.
So yes, it's a big improvement, because at that time they had the better.
Yeah.
You know.
So it made
the
playing field a little more level.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Now, where you reside at now? Are you still here
in
Franklinton?
Los Angeles, California.
Los Angeles.
Yes.
Now, we know there's a lot of the students that live other places, New York, Carolina, and all around the United States. How did you get to Los Angeles?
Actually, when I graduated from high school, I started at Southern University in Baton Rouge, and I ended up in New Orleans.
Mm-hmm.
And as a result of Hurricane Katrina, I was forced into retirement, and I moved to Los Angeles to help my brother and sister-in-law run three transitional homes.
Yeah. So you're taking up residence there.
I have started a new career, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, thank you so much, and you guys have done a great job. All of the students here, did you contact some of the people that are here today in the planning and arranging of this?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
We talk quite often.
Yeah.
You know. Yes.
Yeah. We know it must have been a monumental task.